So recently I've been doing quite a few site inspections to inspect screw piers and footings, and today I would like to share with you a problem that you might come across one day so that you are prepared to come up with a solution. I've built these two models in rubber to illustrate the possible consequences of not getting the screw pile location right. So the strip footing is represented by the purple beams, and the superstructure is represented by the brown and blue beams and columns. And I drew these six columns under the strip footings to represent the screw piles. But before we go ahead, just a heads up, this is not how you model piles, okay? For a proper model, you do need to divide the bars and input springs with elastic coefficients corresponding to the soil properties. But to simplify the model, we will run with this simplification. So on the left-hand side structure, the piles are central to the strip footing, as we can see here. And on the right-hand side structure, the piles are offset 150 millimeters. If we run the calculations, and check the results here, we're gonna see that the structure on the right-hand side with the off-center piles are deflecting a lot towards the y-axis. So this is one of the problems that you're gonna come across if you have eccentric footings. Now we can check the torsion as well. Let's turn the deformation off, apply, then let's go to which one's torsion here, MX, MY, or MZ? I don't know. So let's check the local system. The local system tells us that the strip footing axis on axis is the blue one. What's blue one? Blue one is axis. So that's what we're gonna check. We're gonna check the torsion on the strip footing. So let's check MX. So now we introduce torsion to the footing. What other problem we have here? Well, we probably have introduced bending moment to the piles as well. So let's check bending moment to the piles. There we go. Here we don't have bending moments on the piles, but now we have bending moment on the piles. So all of this can be a problem if you haven't accounted for these internal forces in the design. So let's suppose you came across a situation like that, and then you're gonna ask me, Gabriel, how can I fix that? So that's simple. I'm gonna show you right now. You will have to run strip footings to counteract the eccentricity. It's the same concept of strap footing which I explained in this video, and I will leave the link of the video in the description below. So if you want to learn more about this, you just go and check that out. So now all that bending moment created by the eccentricity is actually taken by the strip footings. And let's check what happens to the deflection. So the deflection of the structure gets back to normal. Again, it is important that you understand these concepts before you go out and do inspections by yourself. So if you're a student or a graduate engineer, you build confidence to talk to contractors and builders by showing that you understand what you're talking about. So that was it for today, fellows. I hope this video was helpful to you. If you want to learn how to design a retaining wall like a pro engineer, I've put together an ebook. The link is in the description below. There is a coupon code for 25% discount, cheap as, and the coupon will expire. So hurry up and see ya, fellas.